For the filmmakers, finding an actress to play opposite Pierce Brosnan was equally challenging. They found her in Renee Russo, star of Get Shorty and Lethal Weapon 4.
This is an elegant crime done by an elegant person. It's not about the money.
Renee is someone who I admired from afar, whose work I've enjoyed. I always think she's got an accessibility and a femininity and a strength and a sense of humor about herself within her work and how she addresses herself on screen. And I thought that we'd go well together.
Are you trying to, are you trying to imply that I had something to do with that painting?
Trying. Thank you. No, I wouldn't call it an attempt.
What's your take from this?
5% of the value recovered.
Oh. Bounty hunter.
If you like.
Always get your man?
Mm-hmm.
Think you'll get me?
Oh, I hope so.
I wanted an actress that the audience could fall in love with, and that's the universal thing that every time she's been out, every movie she's in, no matter what she's playing, the audience falls in love with her. And I figured that was a requisite in a love story, is that, you know, before they can fall in love with each other, the audience individually has to love each other.
Renee Russo would play Catherine Banning, an updated version of the investigator previously played by Faye Dunaway.
You can take $100 million off the wall and waltz right out the front door. Oh, that's good.
Faye Dunaway has a wonderful magic, and Steve McQueen had his, and together the chemistry was wonderful, and they had what they had. And we couldn't duplicate that. So, and going into a film, you never know what the chemistry will be with another person. You kind of have to go in and trust, and it's about the director and your leading man and yourself, and you never know if it'll fizzle or go flat, or you don't know what the chemistry will be.
May I ask you a very personal question?
Why not?
Would you like another hit of espresso? Would you like another?
Like another hit of espresso?
Hmm.
That's the very personal question?
That's as good as it gets.
Oh, excuse me. May I ask you a very personal question?
Oh, sure, by all means.
Do you really think I'm going to sleep with the man I'm investigating? Hmm?
In the original movie, once they screwed, they, the fire went out between the two of them. Suddenly, Faye Dunaway was laying on the bed next to him, and it was like it was over. That was something that I didn't want to happen. So, I mean, I think you'll see in this movie that it only really gets started once they...
Playful tribute to the original film, Faye Dunaway was cast as Thomas Crown's psychiatrist.
What's happened?
Happened?
Whenever I talk, while you're tuning out what I say, the corners of your mouth go up. You're enjoying something. It's not me. What is it?
An entertainment.
Very little entertains you, so I can easily guess. A worthy adversary? Hmm? Did someone swindle you?
People have asked me, how did you possibly get Faye to do this? It wasn't hard. I don't know, I took her to dinner and said, would you do this? I'd love to have you do it. She said, yeah.
If you found a female mirror image and think you're going to form a rewarding relationship...
Think again? I thought it was a very clever, bright idea. And when she said yes, then that gave us also a great affirmation and confirmation that, you know, we had a good script.
Rounding out the supporting cast was comedian and actor Dennis Leary as Detective Michael McCann.
You waltz in there without even a heads up, without one word to me, or anyone else in the department for that matter.
I had a little chat with him, yes.
You had a little chat? You told him balls out he was a suspect.
I cut through the crap, all right?
I'm at work at the precinct with all these guys that I've probably worked with for years. For this woman to walk in the middle of it, I mean, of course you would all of a sudden just go, oh, my God.
I wish she was here every day. And it's very smart. I really think it's fun to watch Pierce angling his way through his relationship with her and my character trying to get a break.
Despite some changes to the storyline, several scenes from the original film were kept relatively intact.
I could get used to this.
Hold on.
Even the Oscar-winning song, Windmills of Your Mind, was re-recorded for the new film by British singer-songwriter Sting. After several weeks filming in New York, the cast and crew flew to the exotic Caribbean island of Martinique for the scene set at Thomas Crown's holiday hideaway.
You're transferring assets. Getting ready to run.
And suppose I did run. Then what would you have? Not the painting, but the $5 million fee, not me.
Yes.
Suppose I gave you 10.
After nearly 3 years of preparation, principal photography, and post-production, The Thomas Crown Affair was released at U.S. cinemas in August 1999.
Switch the paint.
Oh, that's good.
Stay with them.
The new film earned more in its opening weekend than the original made in its entire box office run.
It's not about the money.
So just how big of a thief are you?
Dazzling audiences and critics all over again.
It's a love story between a pair of crocodiles.
And whose head are you after?
Yours.
Thomas Crown was back in business.